just 72 hours to try and fix the worst of Gaza's devastation. Like the sewage pipes, which have been spewing raw effluent for more than 2 weeks.
The municipality is so busy for working now. I work with my money now, work these lines.
We need water to drink.
To try and get water running again to thousands of homes. To repair transmission lines from Israel, up to 7 hours of power a day now after more than a week with almost no electricity at all. Aid groups are distributing mattresses, water and basic supplies to last for just a few days. But tens of thousands like Ayman Kafada and his family have been left homeless. I don't even know where my house is, he says. Where is the road? Where is my neighbor's home? He says repeated Israeli airstrikes flattened the entire neighborhood. Rebuilding isn't so much a question of when, but how.
And this was a combination of what? Airstrikes, artillery, do you know?
Everything. Tanks, airstrikes.
Hatim Husama's factory made pavers for roads and concrete ready mix for buildings. Just one of more than 60 construction companies, according to Palestinian officials, which were targeted by Israel.
You cannot rebuild Gaza again until these kind of factories rebuild. Look, this is what we produce.
Hatim doesn't know why his factory was a target. He sold only to the UN and aid groups, all of it, he says, closely monitored by Israel.
We are not following Hamas policies. We are following Israel policies. And even though they destroyed our business, they destroyed our factories, and they want peace. How?
Israel's prime minister wants reconstruction here linked to long-term demilitarization. Or as some in Israel describe it, for every truckload of cement that comes in, a truckload of rockets goes out. Hamas, though, is insisting as long as Israel has a military, they want one too. John Vause, CNN, Gaza.